On this part, I'm going to be explaining on the background of tea and its fermentation. Tea is one of the most consumed aromatic drinks. Besides water, people from all over the whole wide world will drink tea, where India is the largest producer of tea and the second largest producer is China. Based on the degree of fermentation, there are various types of tea that can be found. For instance, green tea, white tea, oolong tea, and black tea. Different types of tea have different characteristics in terms of aroma, appearance, infusion color, as well as taste. In recent studies, drinking tea has been proven to be beneficial towards our health. For example, it can lower the risk of heart diseases, may aid in weight loss, and regulate blood sugar. It has been proven that tea fermentation assists in the contribution towards the country's economy. Dark tea is a post-fermented tea which is produced through a fermentation process with the help of microorganisms. Pu'er tea is one of the major examples of dark tea. Dark tea contains a plethora of bioactive components like alkaloids, flavonoids, free amino acids, pigments, peptides, polysaccharides, and volatile compounds.
There are two types of tea fermentation. First, solid-state fermentation. This fermentation happens in the absence or low moisture condition, such as the fermentation of pu'er tea leaf. Another type is the liquid-state fermentation, where a solid culture is fermented in the liquid, such as the kombucha tea.
The type of tea leaves that are used for tea fermentation actually originate from the same plant. The botanical name for the tea plant is Camellia sinensis. This plant has been cultivated and consumed for hundreds of years. Camellia sinensis has two main varieties, which are Camellia sinensis var sinensis, which is milder, mellower character, and Camellia sinensis var acemica, which is generally heartier and more robust.
The microbial flora isolated from the pipe fermentation process and pu'er tea include Aspergillus, yeast, Rhizopus, Penicillium, and Burkholm. Among these microorganisms, the dominant position of Aspergillus niger, yeast, and Rhizopus alternately change under different environmental conditions or during processing. There is also bacteria present in the tea fermentation, but the number of bacteria is so small that no pathogenic bacteria are found. Among the microorganisms found involved in fermentation, Aspergillus niger in pu'er tea account for about 80% of the total number of microorganisms. Aspergillus niger is used to degrade tea polyphenol of pu'er tea in a solid fermentation system, and the enzyme extracted by Aspergillus niger is applied in the transformation of the green tea catechin and improve their antioxidant activity.
The processing of tea leaf involves 10 steps. Plucking, wittering, destructing, oxidizing, fixing, sweltering, rolling, drying, aging, and sorting. Oxidizing and aging is often known as the fermentation step in the tea industry. During oxidizing, the enzyme polyphenol oxidase released from the destruction of tea leaf will interact with the oxygen to break down the chlorophyll and release tannins. This brings out the flavor and aroma in the tea leaf. The leaf will change from greenish to coppery brown. This process requires a warm and moist environment. Temperature are kept between 80 to 85 Fahrenheit, and the length of oxidation process leads to different types of true tea. Aging is the step which is not often required in the tea processing. However, it is needed for some tea to reach its potential flavor. In this stage, the tea leaf have prolonged bacterial and fungal fermentation in a warm and humid environment. This technique is called Wo Dui, which involves pounding, dampening, and turning of tea leaf in a manner much akin to composting. This technique ensures even fermentation and increases the value of tea leaf. The longer the pounding time, the deeper the color of the leaf, and the stronger the aroma of the tea.
Commonly, many types of tea come from the same plant, such as Camellia sinensis. Still, the different kinds of tea resulted from additional tea manufacturing progress according to its degree of tea fermentation. The term fermentation relates to how much enzymatic oxidation is allowed by letting the freshly harvested tea leaves dry. Moreover, teas are classified based on the degree of fermentation: non- and light-fermented, semi-fermented, fully-fermented, and post-fermented. Non- and light-fermented teas have an oxidation rate of up to 10% and retain their natural color and properties. For example, green tea, yellow tea, and jasmine-scented tea fall into this category. The next one is semi-fermented, which is further broken down into three levels of fermentation: light for 10% to 20%, medium 20% to 50%, and heavy 50% to 80%. This tea has a delicately fragrant aroma and produces a faint yellow to brown tint. Examples would be Puchong tea for light, Oolong tea for medium, and Champagne Oolong for heavy. Furthermore, another degree of fermentation is fully fermented, whereby part of the insoluble components in the tea leaves plant tissue becomes soluble and easily soluble, resulting in its flavor, aroma, and color, which will be stronger as the fermentation process continues. The type of tea to fall under this category is black tea. Lastly, post-fermented tea refers to tea that have been allowed to ferment before being halted and then fermented again. An example of a tea that undergoes a post-fermented process is a pu'er tea.
The very first application usages of tea is that it helps with photoprotective activity, where tea leaf extract absorbs ultraviolet radiation due to which it protects the skin against its harmful effects. Next, it is also used for anti-cellulite and slimming properties, where it maintains a slim figure, reduces cellulite and removes toxic products from the body. Moreover, it is also used for skin, where it reduces the increase sebum production. Next, it is also used for excessive greasy hair and dandruff. Finally, it is also used as skin microcirculation, where it improves skin microcirculation due to the strong antioxidant properties that have a protective activity towards prostacyclin.